Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube. In this video, I want to walk you through Git integration with Microsoft Fabric, specifically with Power BI reports. Git integration is actually supported with lakehouses, notebooks, paginated reports, Power BI reports, and the semantic models. And I'm sure more will come later, but I wanted to just focus in on how do we set up Git? How do we actually get a Power BI report going with this from a version control perspective? Because a lot of folks had asked for source control capabilities, and this is it. So enough of all this talking, you know, we like to do it here on Guy in the Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. We're going to start our journey inside of Azure DevOps. As of the recording of this video, the Git integration options that are available inside of Microsoft Fabric are leveraged through Azure DevOps Git repos, not Git repos that are hosted inside of GitHub. So if that is something that you want to see, definitely go out to ideas.fabric.microsoft.com and vote that up. I'm sure it will come at some point. Of note, DevOps on premises is not supported, so it has to be the cloud-based version of this. All right, so I went ahead and created a project. I've got a Git repo here or repository, and I've already cloned this to my local machine. So it's sitting inside of my D drive, inside of my source folder. And so that's what we're going to be working off of here. So the first thing I want to do here is I'm coming into Power BI Desktop, and to leverage Git integration inside of Power BI Desktop, we have to use what's called a Power BI project file. And to use that, we've got to go enable the preview feature. So we're going to go over to preview features, and you will see Power BI project PBIP save option. That needs to be selected. You hit okay, restart Power BI Desktop, and you're good to go. This is a classic PBIX. Can't believe I just used the word classic there, but there it is. So this is a PBIX file. It's a single binary file. And what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go ahead and do a save as. You'll see here that you can choose PBIP project, not template. And then I'm just going to go ahead and browse my devices, and I'm going to go to D source Git repo. This is where I want to save it. And I'm going to choose save as type. And I'm going to say Power BI project file PBIP. So let's go ahead and hit save. When we go to that Git demo folder, you'll see what it saved out here. It actually saved out a PBIP file. We've got our reports, and we've got our data set or the semantic model. So these items are now there, and inside of there, we've got JSON files, which are just text files, which we can apply source control to. This is on my local machine. It's not up in the cloud yet. So if you go to Azure DevOps and the Git repo there, you're not going to see it there. So how do we get it there? We got to get it into Azure DevOps first. Then we can play around with it with Microsoft Fabric. We have to do what's referred to as a push. Ideally, what you would do is do a branch as part of this. I'm in the main branch right now, so you'll see that because of the yellow color in main. And if I do git status, you'll see here that it's saying, hey, there's some items here that we need to add to commit. I'm actually going to create a new branch for this. I think that's cleaner. So I'm going to do git checkout dash b initial file. So this is going to create a branch called initial file, and we're going to go over to that branch. So now you'll see the yellow change to initial file. If we do git status again, we still have our items here. So let me go ahead and we're going to add these items and do a commit. I know this is a lot of stuff from a Git perspective. You may not be familiar with Git, but you should learn it. In this case, the way Git tracks things is through what's called a commit. And so what I did just now is I added files to a staging, and then I added that staging to the commit. So now I've created a commit that is part of that repo. It's still all on my local machine. So we got to get this up to the actual cloud, as it were. So Azure DevOps, right? And so this is done by way of what's called a push. And so I am going to push this to the cloud. And then from the cloud, I can do what's referred to as a pull request to get it from one branch to another. Because I just created the branch, it's giving me an error, basically says it doesn't know where to put it to. From this branch's perspective, it doesn't know anything about Azure DevOps. So I need to set that up. And really, you can just copy and paste this line here. And now it's pushed everything up to Azure DevOps. You can see that by the line, the guyinacube.visualstudio.com/git demo. And if I do git status again, everything's up to date. So we're good to go. So now if we go back to Azure DevOps and we refresh, we don't see anything. That's because we're in the main branch. And so let's go over to initial file, and now we'll see items are here. So now we need to get these items into main, and then we can continue. So I'm going to go ahead and create a pull request. If you've got multiple people working on things, I've just found as a best practice, the way that I can quickly visualize which pull requests are mine is I just add an emoticon in front of it. So I do a fist bump, and then let's do create. It's there. So I will complete, which will do the merge. And that is taking the files from initial file branch into main. If we go back to files, we go back to main, and now we see these items inside of main. Whew, that was a lot. We haven't even gotten to the fabric stuff. I know, hang in there. And if you want to learn more about Git, go to git-scm.com. Also, you can go to GitHub, and there's a lot of great information out on GitHub as well. These are common practices for doing things. Okay, let's go to the fun stuff. Let's go to Microsoft Fabric. So I've got two workspaces that are here. We've got Git Dev. I'm going to treat this as my development workspace. And then I've got another one called Git. And so that'll be the production workspace. So let me just go ahead and pin Git Dev. All right, so we're going to go between these two. So the first is Git Dev. So we're going to go to workspace settings, and we're going to go to Git integration, and we'll see that I've got my Azure DevOps piece. We're going to do Guy in a Cube. We'll do project. Git repo is Git demo. And now we've got a choice here from a branch perspective. What do we want to actually create? For this case, I'm just going to go ahead and log this, and I'm going to do a branch that's assigned specifically to a given workspace. You could do different repos for different workspaces themselves. You can do different branches for workspaces. A lot of different ways you can segment this and to control what's going on. I'm going to go and create a branch that's called dev and prod, and then the workspaces will be assigned to those different branches. All right, so I've gone and created those two branches with inside of Azure DevOps, or you can do it right here. And so I'm going to select the dev branch, and you can even go a step further and choose a folder within a branch. Like I said, lots of options here. So figure out how you want to organize yourself here, and then you can go forward and do that. So for Git folder, I'm not going to do anything. So I'm going to do connect and sync. And right now it's syncing the items from the Git branch into my workspace. So we should see the Power BI report and the semantic model. Life is good. Now here's the problem. When you use Git integration for this, womp womp, no data. It's not going to sync the data. It just syncs the schema, right? The model definition. And so you've got to go through now and set up the different data as part of it and get the model refreshed. And then the report will work at that point. Just like a good cooking show again, if we go into the report, bam, we've got data. All right, Adam, now what? You got the report and data set from a Git repo. We set up the data, we refresh the model. Our report's working, but this is development, right? How do I translate this to prod? We can work with the report and the model either on premises, so like on your working machine itself through Power BI Desktop, or you can actually work with it in the web, and those items will all be synced back and forth. So first off, I'm going to go to Power BI Desktop here, and we're in the file. So I'm just going to say new page, and let's just go add internet sales amount. We'll change it to a bar chart, and we'll add month. So I'm just adding a new page called page one, and we've added a visual on there, right? So I'm going to go ahead and save that. Remember, I did that locally, right? So we got to go back up to the cloud, right? So we got to do the whole push, pull request, all that jazz. So if I do git status, it's going to show that I've got a modified item here. Now, I want to make sure I'm doing this in the dev branch because that's what's assigned to the given workspace itself. Now, from a Git perspective, again, lots of different ways you can do this. I could actually set up a working branch where these are my changes and I get those pumped into dev, or I can go to dev directly. So you can see here, I'm actually in a branch called working dev, and then we'll do a pull request over to the dev branch that's aligned to the workspace. I know it's a lot. I'm sorry, bear with me here. And so if we do git status, you'll see that a report file has been modified. So we'll do the same thing we did before. So I'm going to add it to a staged area, and then I'm going to actually commit the change. And now that is part of a commit. So now what I can do is I can do git push, and that sends it up to the cloud. Now let's go back to the repo. So if we go to working dev, we'll see the changes. I'll do a pull request, and we're going to put that into dev. Create, and then we'll complete it. Complete merge. Bam, it's merged. And so now if we go back to dev, which is what our workspace is aligned to, we should see the actual change. So now it's telling us, hey, there's been a change. Microsoft Fabric is telling you, hey, there's an updated commit that's sitting in Azure DevOps that's not represented inside of your workspace. What do you want to do with it? And so what we want to do is we want to pull those changes in. And so it's going to do this with what's called a synchronization. So if we click on source control here in the dev branch, we'll see, hey, there's an item here that's been updated. And you'll see it here also. It says update required. So let's just say update all. All right. And if we go into the report now, we now see that new page and we see the chart that we put on instead of the overview page. So I did some changes locally, put those up into Git, and then updated the workspace with the Git items, and everything's great. So now let's do the other part of this. What if I edit it in the web? I can just go in and edit the report and it'll take these changes. But before I do that, let's actually get this set up into the actual prod branch itself. So let me go over to the Git workspace settings. I'm going to set this up like I did the other one, but in this case, I'm going to choose the prod branch, and we're going to connect and sync. All right, these are synchronized, but now I got to set up the data set because the report doesn't work yet. So hang on. All right, and our items have been synced. The report is there, everything works, life is good. So now one thing in that report in the prod workspace, the new page I created is not there because it only exists in dev. I haven't moved it over to prod yet. So I need to do a pull request on the Azure DevOps side to get it from dev to prod, at which point the prod workspace will pick this up. So let's go back here and we're gonna go over to the pull request tab and I'm gonna say new pull request. And what I wanna do is I wanna take whatever's in dev and I wanna move it to prod. Remember, I like my little emoticon, new page to prod, and then we'll hit create and then we'll complete. And if I come back to Power BI, we're in our production workspace and we should see an update come here from a source control perspective. And there it is. We've got a report item, so we'll say update all. And now if we go into our report, we should see the new page here, which is great. But I didn't mean to push that into prod. What do I do? So now let's go and back into dev. We'll remove that page and see what happens. And we'll do this all from the web browser too. So we're not gonna go to Power BI desktop. So I'm gonna move over to my git dev and we're gonna go into the report. Let's just say we're gonna go to edit. We're going to delete this page and we'll come back to our overview page and then file, save. So that is saved now and you'll see that we have an uncommitted change here. So this is similar to what happened when we did it on-prem, right? So if we made a change in desktop, we did git status, it would say, hey, you got some uncommitted items here. You need to do something with them. And so we'll have to do the same thing. We've got to stage them, commit them, and then get a pull request to get them over to prod. So let's go to source control and we'll see which items do we want. So we want the report and what commit message do we have? So this is kind of doing the staging and commit at the same time. And so we'll say remove page and then we'll do the commit and bam, we've made that commit itself. And so this has actually already pushed it into that dev branch. Now what we need to do is come back to this pull request page and we'll say new pull request. Make sure you get the branches right. So we're going to go dev to prod and we're going to do that. Remove the page, create, complete. And when we go back to our production workspace, we should see the update there. That's great. And we're going to update all of the items, which in this case is just the report page. If we go back into the report now, you'll notice that extra page I added is now gone. And you can go back and forth. You can do the web page. You can do this from Power BI desktop. This is a Git repository, right? So it's a centrally managed item that multiple contributors can put into. And it is a concept of commits and rollbacks, pull requests, pushes, all of these things exist with inside of this environment. Let me know in the comments if you played around with this. Do you have plans to implement this into your DevOps experience? Also, I'll have links down in the description to more information about this. Thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.